Hello everyone, welcome to this training tutorial on drug discovery and the role of the pharmaceutical industry. In this session, we'll take you behind the scenes of one of the most complex, costly, and critical processes in modern science: discovering new medicines. Whether it's a new antibiotic, a life-saving cancer therapy, or a vaccine, every approved drug starts with a single idea and a long road ahead. To help you follow this journey clearly, we've divided the tutorial into two parts. In part one, we'll explore the overall process of drug discovery, what it involves, where it begins, and how the pharmaceutical industry drives innovation forward. We'll look at how potential treatments are identified, tested, and developed, and how industry professionals from research to medical affairs play a vital role in moving a molecule from the lab bench to the bedside. In part two, we'll shift our focus to the phases of clinical research, the essential steps a drug must pass through once it enters human testing. From first-in-human safety studies to large-scale trials and post-marketing surveillance, we'll break down each phase, explain why it matters, and show how it fits into the broader picture of ensuring safety, efficacy, and real-world value. So let's get started with part one and discover how science, strategy, and collaboration come together in the search for new treatments. So, what exactly is drug discovery? Drug discovery is the process of identifying new candidate medications. But it's far more than mixing chemicals in a lab. It's about understanding disease biology, targeting specific mechanisms, and engineering safe and effective molecules that can alter the course of a disease. That is to say, it all begins with a deep understanding of the disease, its causes, pathways, and unmet medical needs. The journey can be divided into five main stages. The first stage is the target identification and validation. Scientists search for biological targets, usually proteins or genes, that play a key role in the disease process. Once identified, these targets must be validated to prove they can be safely and effectively modulated. The second stage is the hit discovery and lead optimization. Using technologies like high-throughput screening or AI-driven simulations, researchers test thousands, sometimes millions, of compounds. The hits that show promise are refined into leads, which are further modified to improve potency, safety, and bioavailability. Then we come to the third stage, which is the preclinical testing. This is where promising compounds are tested in lab models and animals to assess safety, toxicity, and efficacy. It's also when scientists develop a formulation and begin to plan how the drug might be manufactured. The fourth stage is the clinical trials, which, by the way, will be explained later in the second part of this tutorial. Once a candidate passes preclinical testing, it moves to human trials, phase 1 through phase 3, where safety, dosing, and therapeutic benefits are carefully measured. Finally, we come to the fifth stage, which is the regulatory review, and approval data from clinical trials are submitted to agencies like the FDA or the EMA. If approved, the drug can finally reach the market. So these are the five stages of drug discovery. But this isn't the end of the road. Phase 4, or post-marketing surveillance, continues to monitor the drug's safety in the real world. Now let's focus on the role of the pharmaceutical industry in this process. Pharmaceutical companies are not just funding entities, they are innovation engines. They assemble teams of scientists, clinicians, regulatory experts, medical affairs leaders, and market access professionals to guide a drug from molecule to market. Their roles include investing billions in research and infrastructure, building collaborations with academic institutions, biotech startups, and government bodies, ensuring ethical and compliant clinical development, preparing manufacturing and distribution at scale, communicating medical value to regulators, healthcare professionals, and payers, and most importantly, ensuring patient safety at every stage. Additionally, medical affairs teams in the industry play a very important role to align drug development with real-world needs, address medical education gaps, and collect post-approval data. What about the challenges facing drug discovery? We got to understand that despite breakthroughs in AI, genomics, and precision medicine, drug discovery remains high risk. Only 1 out of 10,000 compounds typically reaches the market, and the process can take 10 to 15 years, with average costs exceeding $2 billion per approved drug. This is why pharmaceutical companies must be both innovative and resilient, managing risk, timelines, and regulatory requirements, while always keeping the patient in mind. Why does this matter? Because every successful drug has the potential to change lives. It may relieve suffering, extend survival, or even cure disease. And while the science is remarkable, it's the collaboration between researchers, regulators, industry, and the medical community that truly powers discovery. In this system, every role matters, from the scientist in the lab to the medical affairs professional in the field. Let's elaborate more on the cost, because drug discovery isn't just time intensive. It's financially demanding on an extraordinary scale. As mentioned before, developing a single new medicine can take anywhere from 10 to 15 years, with costs often exceeding $2 billion. These figures aren't just tied to the drug that reaches the market. They also account for the thousands of compounds that fail during development, the infrastructure needed to support global research, the regulatory requirements that must be met, and the highly specialized talent involved at every step. The reality is, modern drug development is built on cutting-edge science and innovation. We are no longer dealing with simple chemical compounds alone. Today's medicines are often biologically engineered, highly specific treatments that require sophisticated technologies and platforms. For instance, consider targeted therapies in oncology. These are designed to home in on specific genetic mutations within cancer cells, offering patients more precise and often more effective options with fewer side effects than traditional chemotherapy. Or look at next-generation vaccines and monoclonal antibodies, which are built on decades of research in immunology and molecular biology. These innovations are transforming the way we treat complex diseases, but they come at a price. That price doesn't just reflect the cost of ingredients. It reflects the investment in years of research, clinical trials, regulatory compliance, manufacturing scale-up, and the enormous risk of failure. So when a breakthrough medicine finally reaches the market, its price represents not only the value it brings to patients, but also the depth of scientific discovery and the resources required to make it a reality. Let's now shift gears to talk about the clinical research phases, phase 1 through phase 4. This is where a promising compound, after going through rigorous preclinical testing, finally begins its journey in humans. Each phase has a specific purpose, and understanding what happens at each step helps us appreciate just how much effort goes into getting one drug approved. Phase 1, is it safe? We start with phase 1, the very first time the drug is tested in humans. At this point, we're not asking if the drug cures the disease. We're asking a much more fundamental question: is it safe? This phase usually involves a small number of participants, maybe 20 to 100 people. In most cases, these are healthy volunteers, unless the drug is for something like cancer or another serious condition, in which case patients might be involved from the start. Here, researchers are trying to figure out how the drug behaves in the body, how it's absorbed, metabolized, and excreted. This is where we study the pharmacokinetics and look closely for any side effects or dose-limiting issues. It's a critical gate. If the drug can't demonstrate safety here, it doesn't move forward. Phase 2. Does it work in patients? If phase Y looks good, the drug moves into phase 2. And now we're working with patients, real people who have the disease we're trying to treat. Phase 2 is where things start to get more specific, and it's often split into two parts, phase 2A and phase 2B. In phase 2A, we're looking for what we call proof of concept. We want to know, does the drug show early signs of doing what we hope it will? We're still learning about safety, but we're beginning to focus on whether the drug is having a meaningful effect on the disease. Then comes phase 2B. This is about finding the right dose. What's the optimal amount that gives us good results without unacceptable side effects? This phase usually involves a few hundred patients and helps determine the best design for the next big step. Phase 3. Many promising drugs never make it past phase 2. It's a tough stage because this is where the real-world complexity of the disease and patient diversity begins to show. Phase 3, is it better than what we already have? Now we get to phase 3. These are the large-scale trials, the ones that involve hundreds, sometimes thousands, of patients across different countries and hospitals. Here, we're looking to answer the big question. Is this drug better than the current standard of care? These studies are often double-blinded and randomized. Patients may receive either the new drug, an existing treatment, or a placebo, depending on the condition being studied. Phase 3 is where we gather the evidence that regulators will review. We're measuring real-world effectiveness, closely monitoring side effects, and making sure the results hold up across large, diverse groups. This phase takes time, resources, and careful coordination. It's also the stage where things get exciting, because if the data is strong, the drug may be on its way to approval. Phase 4, what happens after approval? Even after a drug is approved and launched, the work continues. This is where phase 4 or post-marketing surveillance begins. In phase 4, the drug is out in the real world, being used by many more patients, sometimes in ways that weren't fully captured during trials. That's why we need ongoing monitoring. It helps us catch rare side effects, see how the drug works in special populations, and gather more data on long-term safety. It's also a time for generating real-world evidence, exploring outcomes in different settings, and even running additional studies to support new indications or regulatory commitments. This stage reflects a shared responsibility between pharmaceutical companies, regulators, healthcare providers, and patients to make sure that the benefits of the drug continue to outweigh the risks. So why does all this matter? Because every single phase, from that very first human dose to years after the drug hits the market, is designed to protect patients. The process is long, expensive, and full of obstacles. But it's the only way to ensure that new treatments are not only effective, but safe, reliable, and meaningful in people's lives. And when a drug finally gets approved, it's not just a scientific win, it's a human one. As we close this session, remember, drug discovery isn't just about chemistry or biology. It's about commitment, strategy, and purpose. And the pharmaceutical industry plays a pivotal role, turning scientific vision into treatments that can reach every corner of the world. Thank you for watching. Stay curious, stay informed, and continue shaping the future of healthcare.